9 साल पहले शुरू हुआ एंटरप्रेन्योर इंडिया का सफर अब और भी बड़ा और बेहतर हो रहा है। हर बार की तरह इस बार भी हमने मुलाकात की जाबाज एंटरप्रेन्योर से, जो अपना सब कुछ झोंककर अपने सपनों को सच करने में लग जाते हैं।
Good morning to all of you and a very, very warm welcome to the Entrepreneur 2019, the 9th edition of the Entrepreneur series. A lot of things have changed around us in the last 5 years. We almost moved away from position into sharing everything we have today. In fact, the younger generation, the millennial generation, doesn't want to own anything. Now, when you have a mindset of not wanting to own anything, this calls for a very different kind of economy being built, a very different kind of business and business frameworks happening out there. Some of the areas where I felt the biggest opportunity is going to come, enterprise tech. The next 2 years are going to pretty much see a transformation of existing enterprises, whether they are corporates or whether they are small and medium enterprises. With electric vehicles being the number one sort of priority with both the government as well as with startups, I think the opportunity of micro mobility is only going to become bigger. PropTech. Do feel that PropTech is going to be one big opportunity and would also be one of the factors which will bring real estate really back in motion. Remote education, remote healthcare, remote in services being able to provide only because there is 5G services that will be available, and this will bring a very different business landscape in the coming times.
Niti Aayog ke CEO Shri Amitabh Kak ne bataya कि ऐसे कौन से क्षेत्र हैं जिसमें देश आगे बढ़ रहा है और किन क्षेत्रों से उन्हें सबसे ज्यादा उम्मीद है।
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिया इज ग्रोइंग एट अराउंड 7% पर एनम, बट आवर चैलेंज इज रियली टू ग्रो एट हाई रेट्स ऑफ 9-10% पर एनम, ईयर आफ्टर ईयर, ईयर आफ्टर ईयर फॉर 3 decades और मोर। इज नॉट पॉसिबल टिल वी डू नॉट बिल्ड ग्रेट एंड रियली ट्रूली टॉप क्लास एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप। We've tried to make India easy and simple. We'd made it quite complex and complicated earlier. We scrapped a number of rules, regulation, procedures. We've jumped up about 65 position in the rules, in the ease of doing business of the World Bank. But most of the business is done in states, and therefore states need to be made easy and simple. We started ranking states. We started naming and shaming them. And we've seen a huge movement forward. We must be open to globalization, and unless we do not penetrate global markets, it will not be possible to grow at high rates. India's process of urbanization has just begun, and therefore India is the only country in the world which is doing 100 smart cities. We are doing 50 metros, we are doing high speed train, we are doing the logistics, the dedicated freight corridors, and we are doing smart cities on the back of these dedicated freight corridors. So you will see a huge amount of business opportunity in urbanization. Water, electricity, storage, mobility will be some of the biggest challenges which India will be confronted with. These are all areas which are waiting to be disrupted, and you need a lot of enterprise and a great entrepreneurship to take this forward. All young entrepreneurs who are here, India is truly a great opportunity. It's an opportunity not merely because of its domestic market. It's a massive opportunity because of the huge amount of disruption that is happening across the world. My only piece of advice will be, don't think about protectionism. Think aggressively. Think of the entire world as your market.
A company sirf kuch logo ka jut nahi hai. Uske alawa bhi bahut kuch hai. Culture, विजन, वैल्यूज, इन्हीं सब विषयों पे हमने बात की श्री सुमन सिन्हा से।
यू हैव नाउ टेकन द स्टेप, यू हैव गॉट योर स्टार्टअप गोइंग एंड यू आर लुकिंग फॉर फंडिंग, यू आर लुकिंग टू गेट योर प्रोडक्ट आउट देयर, यू आर लुकिंग टू गेट योर फर्स्ट कस्टमर। सो दैट्स व्हाट आई कॉल इन सम वेज फेज वन, और लेट्स कॉल इट द सर्वाइवल फेज। वंस यू गेट द फर्स्ट फंडिंग, यू आर इन सम वेज बियॉन्ड दैट सर्वाइवल फेज, एंड यू स्टार्ट देन थिंकिंग अबाउट ओके व्हाट कम्स आफ्टर दैट। And I think one of the things that most entrepreneurs do not think about as hard as they should, how to build the organization as well. And so in a way, what I'm going to tell you today is not about the first steps that you take as a company, but really more about what is required as you start scaling your company up. It's not just good enough to hire people. You also need to have the systems and processes that allow these people to interface with each other, allow a certain way of working to emerge between these people so that they're efficient and effective. The other things that you require that are very critical is you need a culture. And you have to make sure that you shape that culture within your organization. You cannot let a culture just evolve. A culture is represented by what is the vision of the company? Where are you trying to get to? Do people in your organization know what the eventual aim of the organization is? So it's important to tangibilize the vision into some articulated mission steps that are easier to understand and comprehend, that give people actionable steps. Values are very, very critical. What, again, does your organization stand for? If you're about to become an entrepreneur, I would say don't think twice about it. Jump into it, get into it. But as you build your business, please, for heaven's sake, also focus on building your organization, because as you go forward into the future, you'll find that that organization becomes the bedrock of what you're trying to achieve. And as your ambitions grow, and as your aspirations grow, you will find that having that right organization structure is really what allows you to actually keep climbing different levels and keep making your business bigger and bigger and better and better.
I've always idealized my father and always aspired to be like him. And in the process of being like him, I need to run the business like him as well, very successfully. And I have to ensure that it is growing. And I grow it further. Like, I would love to grow it like 10 times bigger than what it is right now. But certainly the hard work and dedication that needs to be replicated, I would say, has to be bought in. And that is what I look forward to doing.
See, India is a country, but it has more than 25 countries within a country, you know, so and every state has a different taste. So basically, we are just going pan-India, we are doing 25 countries in one country. And when we are going global, this Indian market is more price-oriented, there is huge competition, there are a lot of big players in the field. But when we go for the export market, it is more product-driven. Innovative ideas are appreciated, and you have to do something out of the box to stand between the best of the world.
I wish that I should provide affordable quality medicines to every Indian in every cities of India. For that, I am supporting and aggregating small medical store who are facing really a very huge business competition from huge medical malls and online pharmacy. So we are aggregating and supporting them and get their business back. We are doing the marketing. We are providing them the store manager, our software, our all the marketing mediums. We are taking all the small medicals under our roof of Generic Aadhar for being and compete in global market.
For any of the startup, it takes an idea.
We have a regular consistent customer who
approaches us. We want to launch with 4 essential SKUs which we believe will be good in the Indian market, because the Indian consumer today understands.
इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स अब हमारे बीच में हैं और लगातार बढ़ रहे हैं। इलेक्ट्रिक मोबिलिटी के इस दौर पर हमने चर्चा की इस इंडस्ट्री के 2 दिग्गजों से।
There is actually this is something very interesting coming from Bloomberg. They said that we might remember this very moment as the peak of cars, okay, production and sales, especially for private users. The new market is called MaaS, mobility as a service. MaaS combined with AI is a $7 trillion opportunity by 2050. So ownership, private cars, and mobility as a service, shared mobility, they have a very different usage. In ownership, usually, we drive around 2 hours daily. Uber, Ola, they're pushing the usage to the limit, actually 10 times more. When you have a heavy, heavy usage, definitely there is a problem, for example, for the warranty of the battery. Definitely, we have to think about a better way to design, engineer, manufacture, recycle, manage the energy grid, okay, in a better way. It has to be engineered for services, because more and more people are going to use services instead of their own car.
So we've extensively leveraged our knowledge which we've acquired over the automotive sector for the past 6 decades, whether it's bicycles, motorcycles, and use them in electric. This seems to be our future, and our mission going forward is no emission, and that's what we've been doing for the past 10 years. To introduce vehicles which are environmental friendly, easy on the pocket, ease of use. You don't have to go to a gas station to fill up. You can take your battery inside your apartment, charge it. You can swap your battery when it comes to applications, different applications. Usability for different levels of people. So you could have a product which goes 60 kilometer range, or you could have 130 kilometer range or 140 kilometer range, depending on what your usability and what you want out of the vehicle. The revolution is coming. It's inevitable. Disruption is inevitable. So next 10 years, we're going to see a change which we have not seen in the past 50 years. There is going to be a very cohesive joint effort between the charging infrastructure, automotive companies, the government, utilities, in order to bring all of this together and come in for the consumers. And India, as you would have read in the past couple of weeks, we are aspiring to be a global leader when it comes to the electric vehicle mobility. Is the energy density of batteries and the cost of batteries. So batteries are following a Moore's law, whereby the cost of battery technology is coming down every year, and the density is increasing every year. The total cost of ownership of an electric is lower, but the initial purchase price of electric is much higher than that of an IC, simply because of the battery cost. But that is going to change.
Entrepreneur India पर हमने देखे राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस जहां पे सब मेहमानों ने अपनी बात रखी.
In terms of our journey, Supreme Special Steel started about 8 years ago, and the vision was very clear. We wanted to make in India. We wanted to indigenously develop special materials for the strategic sectors. So today we are a full-blown manufacturing company of raw materials, and we supply material for aero engines, for fighter jets, for battle tanks, satellites, rockets, guns, and all these special applications that India may have.
Young business entrepreneur, my suggestion, the young people, they will earn, become a big millionaire or multimillionaire, no problem. But you think for the people, for the your society. You cannot run your business without consumers. I think whole society will be capable, then your business will run properly.
See, digital transformation has become, I would say, the first word in the technology now. So because most of the bigger organizations, you name the top 10 banks in the world, take top 10 automobile companies in the world, everybody's transforming, right? And their requirement is different, and their consumer base is different. So digital transformation is something which should be customizable for the needs of their customers and the relevant market segment. So likewise, every domain, every vertical, they have different problems and different solutions. So that is where we, as an organization, we all, the leadership team and entire engineers that we have, both in US, Uruguay, and India, we are very diversified. We deal with fintech, automobile, healthcare, and manufacturing and supply chain.
एक एक्टर और एक एंटरप्रेन्योर में क्या समानताएं हैं? दोनों किस तरह से अपने विश्वास के दम पर दुनिया जीतना चाहते हैं? ये और कुछ अन्य विषयों पे हमने बात की श्री राजकुमार राव से.
You work with a lot of first-time directors yourself. It's always a huge risk when you're a big actor, but you nevertheless go ahead and take those risks. And you know, I mean, a lot of us out here are actually from the business space. We take a lot of risks ourselves. So, you know, how does it feel?
Once you say yes to it, you have to go all out. And you can't go half-heartedly and thinking that, okay, let me try.
But then you're like co-founders, really, right?
I mean, both of you. Exactly. But I believe in energies a lot. Like, I spend a lot of time with my directors. And before saying yes to it, if I like the energy of that person, if I see that he's also visualizing the film the way I'm seeing it in my mind, and we both are on the same, stage, then I say yes to it. But the moment I feel that, you know, he's seeing it from a very different point of view. He wants to make it like a really masala, though it's not meant to be a really masala entertainer, but he wants to make it because he wants to 100 crores. If that is the motivation, then I'll have my doubts. You know, when the whole team is synchronized, the whole motivation is to tell a good story in the best way possible and not thinking about anything else, it shows in your work.
So do you see yourself getting into bigger and better, or maybe even a production side?
I would love to. I would love to explore my boundaries and production. Eventually, yeah, I think that's my plan. I would love to produce one day. I would also love to be like entrepreneur like you guys. Though I know it is a lot of risk, but I think there's no fun without risk in life. You have to take your chances.
You know, I mean, for entrepreneurship and even in the movie, in the entertainment industry, failures, they come, I mean, you know, you have to live with them. So what are the failures that you probably, you know, you rationally remember?
Well, you learn from your mistakes. I think mistakes are very important. You should make them. Then only, I feel you can grow in life. There are a couple of films I've done, and I'm not equally proud of those films. They're still in my filmography, and they would always be there. But I think I learned my lesson. It doesn't work in your favor. If it doesn't come from your heart, if you don't really feel excited about it, you should really don't go for it.
You know, so it's now becoming quite sort of symbiotic in the industry that, you know, because you have such a huge celebrity image, you can partner today with a young startup. And because of that, and something you believe in and something that you're passionate about, and you can actually be partners or co-founders, as I said, together and make that business bigger. So do you see yourself doing that at some point of time?
Yeah, if anybody's out there who's ready to partner with me, I'm very open with the idea. Yes, I'm very open with the idea. I think there's some great minds out there, and there's so many amazing startups happening. I keep a tab of some of them, but yeah, I'm very open to the idea of you know, going in a partnership with some amazing startup.
Hi, I'm Sanket Agrawal, founder of GlobalCart. We are a mission of to bring most of the innovative product from all around the world to India. We have a launchpad program. So if it's, first of all, it is only for the foreign companies, right? So they want they go to the launchpad and they can apply from there. Our team assists the product, check the product, do the market survey, and if we find the product suitable for the Indian market, we contact them and do the further processing of that.
Veer Das jitna hasate hain utna hi business ke bare mein gambhir hain. आइए सुनते हैं उनका क्या कहना है.
When I came down to India, it was 2006, and I had studied abroad and I had done some acting. And you know, when I came down, there were three or four people who were doing stand-up comedy, but there was nobody performing for kids. So that's why I felt like there was a big, not like bacha party, but you know, they're college kids. So there was nobody talking about, you know, girlfriends and boyfriends. Everybody was talking about bungalows and wives and husbands and jewelry, but nobody was talking about Delhi University. And that's where I sensed that there's an opening here for a young voice in stand-up comedy.
You know, while you've done some work in Bollywood and probably some films, and you've done a great series on Netflix as well, but you know, you've still sort of remained true to your profession, which is stand-up comedy.
With an actor, the tough thing is, agar Friday ko film pit gayi, you have to wait 5 months to reinforce that relationship with the fans. With a comedian, you can be in a flop film on Friday and be on a hit on stage on Saturday and a hit on stage on Sunday. So why would you not take that opportunity to perform for that crowd? You know, it's now at a point where I think the real future of comedy in India is going to be regional comedy. And that's where the money is going to be. You know, who is the next big Punjabi comedian? Who is the next big Gujarati comedian? And what is their voice? And who are they talking about? And that's going to be where comedy will truly scale. When you have the courage that English comedians have, but you're able to do it in Punjabi and Gujarati and have that kind of freedom, I think that's when comedy will truly be global.
You know, another thing is that you've done it across 32 countries. Now, I'm sure humor is sensitive. In some countries, you know, what is humor in India may be considered, you know, a sin in probably a Middle East, or, you know, maybe some other country has some other sort of sense of humor.
We're now at a point where, irrespective of where you are in the world, the more uniquely Indian you can be, it reinforces your voice and your fan base.
Do you want to be opening like a school where you could actually create, promote, help build future stand-up comedians for India?
Well, I mean, this kind of goes with what we're talking about, but I run a business. You know, I employ about 26 people. It's a funded company that gives, you know, turns young comedians into scriptwriters, and we produce films and web series. And I heard a great definition of success that I thought I'd share, and because I haven't achieved it yet. Success is the amount of time that passes between an idea happening in your head and that idea reaching completion.
Entrepreneur of the Year Award, and we'd like to congratulate Mr. Sumant Sinha, Chairman and CEO of Renew Power, for being Entrepreneur of the Year. Many, many congratulations to you, sir. Entrepreneur of the Year in Service Business Education goes to Mr. Akshay Munjal, President at BML University. Congratulations to Mr. Munjal for this award. Congratulations to Mr. Vishal for being Founder of the Year. Many, many congratulations to Mr. Aditya Ghosh, CEO, India and South Asia, Oyo Hotels and Homes, for being Entrepreneur of the Year. The next category is Cross-Border Business Growth, and the winner for this category is Grey Orange. Congratulations to Grey Orange for being the best cross-border business growth. Entrepreneur of the Year in Service Business goes to Mr. Suraj Saharan, co-founder and CPO, and Mr. Sahil Barua.